across thousands of cities and millions of miles. T-Mobile's nationwide 4G network has the U.S. covered from coast to coast. Nationwide 4G coverage from T-Mobile, reaching over 220 million Americans. See for yourself at T-Mobile.com.
Yeah. Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you. I know what you want. You know I got it.
Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you. As long as you want, you know I got it.
Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you.
As long as you want.
Steve Weissman back with the studio update over on ESPN right now. Ole Miss and Pitt in the BBVA Compass Bowl. Ole Miss gets started early. Bo Wallace to Jamez Logan, 14 yards. And Mr. Wallace, the sophomore from Tennessee, had those fans from Ole Miss singing Hotty Toddy one more time to Randall McKay, 27 yards. Wallace started 8 of 8, 64 yards and 2 touchdowns. Could be a long day for Pitt fans. Already saw him losing hoops. Back to Dave.
Thanks, Steve. Ole Miss, boy, they have been geeked up for that game for about a month now, selling over 30,000 tickets. Here, North Dakota State's been jacked up for this as well. Those folks getting out of Fargo, coming down to sunny Frisco, Texas. And they have brought, as Jay mentioned earlier, some of that Fargo Dome noise here to FC Dallas Stadium. Trey Diller, short kick. Dre out to the 25-yard line. Well, the Bison trying to defend their national championship. Of course, the number one seed finished up 13-1 in the regular season. They won in the second round game, beating South Dakota State 28-3. Then things got a little scary for the Bison. They held off Wofford 14-7. And then Georgia Southern had a lead. But late in the game, it was Brock Jensen with a big quarterback keeper after teams called a bunch of timeouts. And they held on to beat Georgia Southern. Here goes Bell. Has Sincere wide open on the far side. He's to midfield and stopped there. Somebody missed an assignment.
And I think it's pretty clear that the speed of Sam Houston on offense is too much for the North Dakota State defense to handle. In this case here, Andre Martin Jr., the cornerback, just gets spun around like a top. By Sincere, he was open the whole time during the
a gain of 26.
I mean, you don't get any more wide open than that.
First down and 10. Bell throws a bullet. Looking for Brandon Wilkerson. That'll go incomplete. Second down and 10 coming up. Marcus Williams on that coverage.
And if I'm defensive coordinator Chris Kleiman, you saw it there from North Dakota State, go back to the strong cover two shell, which they like to use, because I don't believe that they can play man-to-man coverage versus Sam Houston State, the speed at the wide receiver position.
So Sincere back in at quarterback. He wears number 6. He'll get the snap and keep it. He'll cut it back. Sincere to the 45-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play. Sincere on the year, 96 carries coming into this championship game. 574 yards, averages 6 yards a pop. Also scored 5 TDs on the ground. They'll split back out wide. As Bell back in at quarterback. Flanders off to his left. Flanders. 4 carries, 6 yards. But Bell will throw it here. Actually keep it and got some room. Bell picks up the first down to the 36. Andre Martin Jr. brings him down, but not before Bell scoots for 6. Or scoots for the first down.
And this is just a great decision by Brian Bell. Dropping off in the zone coverage, good pass rush, good pocket presence, stays calm, knows where the first down yardage is, and once he gets it, goes down to the ground, secures the football. That's the leadership that Brian Bell's emerged to as being one of the leaders on this offensive unit for Sam Houston.
Flanders makes a couple of guys miss and then falls to the 30-yard line. Give him six on the carry. Boy, Flanders is a guy that is just his highlight reel is pretty special to watch.
The initial contact, he's very compact, 5'9", so he's not very tall, but you'll never see the first guy bring him down. Very tough to tackle in open space, and the yards after contact really separate him from the rest of the running backs in FCS football.
Started his career at Kansas State, where he redshirted as a freshman before coming to Sam Houston State. Bell will keep it, nowhere to run. Not even lost a half a yard. Flanders is the school's all-time leading rusher, just a junior. Two-time All-American, was a Southland Freshman of the Year in 2010, and then 2011 and 12 was their Player of the Year.
Special talent getting better. Time goes on, and just a junior, so he's got some of his best football ahead of him next season.
Third down and four. Bell will keep it, sees a hole, has a first down, and runs right into Martin. And Bell fell awkwardly on that tackle, but he picks up nine, and he's slow to get up.
Great decision by Brian Bell to call his own number. This is just a zone read on the end man of the line of scrimmage. See the defensive end, Ricky Hagen, go down. Bell has the leverage, gets outside, and defensive players don't like when quarterbacks run the football. Andre Martin coming over and hits him with a little bit of force.
Oh, that right leg just awkwardly bent backwards, but Bell stays in the game. Still hobbling on first down and 10. Hands it to Flanders. About a yard to the 20. Boy, Marcus Williams, you know, a lot of times you see those flashy corners. They don't come up and pop you, but Marcus Williams, one of those corners that loves to come get his nose involved in the play.
Good old-fashioned football player. Some people say they don't make them like they used to anymore. Marcus Williams proof of that.
We have played the first 15 of the FCS National Championship game. 3 points on the board. They belong to North Dakota State.
Right now, Match.com is searching. Right now, Match is found. Right now, people who join Match are 3 times more likely to find a relationship than people who don't. Start for free right now.
To make it great for the whole crew, Pizza Hut put all your favorites in one epic box. The Big Dinner Box is loaded with 2 medium pizzas, 5 breadsticks, and your choice of pasta, stuffed pizza rollers, or wings for just $19.99. Now that's how you make it great.
I'm snow, and just like you, the further in the winter we go, the heavier I get. And while your pants struggle to support the heavier you, your roof struggles to support the heavier me. And your cut rate insurance might not pay for this, so get Allstate. You can save money and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Mayhem is everywhere, so get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
Two programs with great tradition. They're going to play tough physical football.
This is a really good team, and I think a great matchup. You know, a little bit of old-fashioned football.
Buckle up, everybody.
That's going to be a slugfest.
The championship game doesn't get more compelling than Notre Dame and Alabama.
It'll be some scene down in South Florida.
You're watching the NCAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Dave Neal along with Jay Walker, Kara Capuano down on the sidelines. And, well, that end of the first quarter came at a good time for Brian Bell. Watch the end of this play and his right leg.
Well, you see the force there. Ooh. I mean, that knee just got twisted. Fortunately, it's just an ankle there, and they had an opportunity to go and really tape it up heavily. But Brian Bell showing you the toughness that he brings from China Spring, Texas. In a game like this, it's going to take a whole lot to keep him on the sideline.
The son of a high school coach, his brother also a successful coach. Football is in his blood. He will watch this one, though, as Sincere comes in the Wildcat. Second down. First play of the second quarter. Sincere keeps it. Nowhere to go. Played well by North Dakota State. Now, remember, the Bison are coming off back-to-back games against option teams, kind of different option teams, but nonetheless, they've played assignment football the last couple of games.
And that's what you have to do when you're taking on the option. Somebody responsible for the pitch man, another responsible for the running back, and you see right there is a great job done by Bobby Ullman, number 10, the safety. They're sliding down the line of scrimmage. He was responsible for the running back, and then you saw Dudzik responsible for the quarterback.
Bell back in on the 10th play of the drive. No flag. Looked like Sincere was just run right out of bounds by Andre Martin on the far side. Had no chance to come back for the ball.
Yeah, they were throwing this ball, underthrown ball there, and it seemed as if Martin just rode him out of bounds completely on the sideline. And you're going to see it at the top of your screen. The ball's in the air. He doesn't even see the ball, and he's still pushing the wide receiver there. They just missed that one.
It will result now in a 38-yard attempt for Miguel Antonio. He missed from 32 earlier. This time the snap is good and the kick is good. So Sam Houston State drives it down and gets the three-pointer on the board, and we're all knotted up, 14-18 to go in the second quarter. College football is on ESPN Sunday night at 9 o'clock Eastern. Darrell Hazels will coach his final game for the 25th-ranked Kent State Golden Flashes as they face Sun Belt Conference champions Arkansas State. The Red Wolves in that GoDaddy.com bowl. Kent State, Arkansas State, Sunday at 9 Eastern on ESPN and also live on the Watch ESPN app.
A little bit of contrast in style there. You talk about Darrell Hazels. Gets the opportunity to coach while Gus Malzahn, head coach at Arkansas State during the season. He's already gone and left down to Auburn, Alabama.
Well, the last couple of coaches at Arkansas State have had some success. One of them leading Ole Miss right now in the BBVA Compass Bowl. Boy, great crowd here. Watching the folks get here 2.5 hours before the game today. There's a lot of activity surrounding this FC Dallas stadium, home to the FC Dallas soccer team. There you go. Like that look. A rematch of last year's championship. North Dakota State won that title. And Houston State trying to grab that trophy today. Ryan Smith. Big hit at the 25, falls forward out to the 29-yard line, a 23-yard return. There is Craig Bohl, the head coach at North Dakota State, now in his 10th season, the second all-time winningest coach in Bison history, the Eddie Robinson Coach of the Year this year, and just got a long contract extension, and talking to him, he's excited to have it, loves being in Fargo, loves everything about North Dakota State. And Willie Fritz, his counterpart, his third year at Sam Houston State, the son of a coach as well, 31-9 with the Bearcats, 20th year overall as a head coach.
Well, I don't know how often you see a football game where both coaches have career winning percentages in the 70s. Tells you they're very effective leaders.
Crockett will make the catch out to the 34-yard line. Give him five. Robert Shaw brings him down. The senior safety out of Converse, Texas.
Well, I know we talked early on, how much longer will North Dakota State continue to try and force feed the passing game? And now I'm starting to get an agreement with you, Dave. I think at some point, if you got here running the football, even if they've got an extra man, you've got to force feed that run game and try to establish control of the line of scrimmage.
Their big run was a 57-yarder by Crockett that set up the first 3 points of the game. Career long run for Crockett. Here comes Smith in motion. They'll fake it to him, and Jensen will try to keep it around the edge, and he will go to the 36. Give him a couple of yards. Kenneth Jenkins and Darius Taylor combined for the tackle.
Kenneth Jenkins again coming up from his free safety position. Oftentimes when the ball is snapped for Sam Houston State, they will have 11 defenders within 7 yards of the line of scrimmage. They really believe in getting everybody involved in tackling the football. I mean, look at this. Take a look at the challenges here. You're going to see the matchup across the board. One-on-one coverage. You go in motion. We've got somebody coming across the formation in motion with you.
On third down. Jensen. Over the middle. Boy, he did a nice job by the few extra seconds to hit Kevin Vaughdlin, and it's a first down.
Vaughdlin's coming from that tight end position, and once you get the mismatches, you're going to find them. They're going with this bunch formation here just to get separation versus the man-to-man coverage. You're going to see Vaughdlin do a good job of sitting down in the hole right there, and then he keeps moving. Great job by Jensen of buying more time so that Vaughdlin can find the second window and make the completion for the first down.
Ball sits at the 44 out of the I formation. Have a stack receiver set near side. Here comes some heat. Handoff. Crockett will take it close to midfield. Give him 5 on the carry. Crockett just a sophomore. Between him and Ojeri, coaches say he's more the downhill runner. Ojeri kind of more elusive. But Crockett had the 57-yarder earlier tonight. Has 3 carries for 63 yards today.
Look at all these bodies around the line of scrimmage. Really trying to make it hard for the Bison to establish the running game.
Crockett. Got hit in the hole by Darius Taylor, the senior linebacker out of Mesquite, Texas, a gain of a yard.
And when you crowd the line of scrimmage like that with an extra body in the box the whole time, there's going to be somebody free around there. And it's so tough for the offensive line to make the calls and the signals on who's going to block who. Trying to do a zone blocking scheme versus this defensive front, very difficult to do.
So third down and 4. Derek Lang will check into the game. He'll stand alongside Brock Jensen. 4 receiver look. Jensen through the hands of Ryan Smith, and it's incomplete. Robert Shaw on the coverage for the Bearcats.
And this is one here where Ryan Smith has to come down with this football. We've got a crossing pattern. Jensen throws this ball in a tight window. Although it was great coverage being applied by Robert Shaw, when you've got man-to-man coverage, that ball hits you in the hands. You've got to secure the football first.
Ben LeCompte to punt it away for the Bison. Trey Diller stands back at the 12. Here's the kick. Boy, it is a tight, booming spiral. That will hit at the goal line and bounce in. Boy, LeCompte hit that about as pure as you're going to hit one. But all for naught, it'll come out to the 20-yard line. Tied at 3, 10:32 to go. Second quarter football in the FCS National Championship game.
Activation initiated. Vision expanding to a 5-inch 1080p HD display and camera. Touch acquiring NFC. Hearing evolving with Beats Audio. Wireless charging activated.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone, it's an upgrade to yourself.
The boys use Capital One Venture Miles for their annual football trip. That's double miles you can actually use. Tragically, their buddy got sacked by blackouts.
But it's our tradition!
That's roughing the card holder.
But with the Capital One Venture card, you get double miles you can actually use! Any fright? Any time.
Scoreboard doesn't lie.
What's in your wallet? I have me on my fantasy team.
Tied at 3 at FC Dallas Stadium. Let's go downstairs, check in with Kara, who has a very special guest alongside.
That's right, Dave. I'm with Drew Pearson, who helped out with the coin toss today. He used to play at Tulsa. Fans probably recognize him a little bit more for his career with the Dallas Cowboys. Drew, very close game. You've been watching intently. What does one of these teams need to do to separate itself?
Yeah, it's been very physical. A lot of emotion on both sides. But I think what both teams need to do is improve on third down situations. That's why we're seeing so many punts here, because they're not converting third down situations.
Dallas Cowboy, three-time Super Bowl attendee yourself. How does the energy here at the FCS Championship compare to those atmospheres?
You know, everything's relative. You know, the Super Bowl is one atmosphere for that stage, and this championship here is another atmosphere for this stage. And this atmosphere here in Frisco at this stadium is very electric today, and it's exciting. It's got me so fired up. I'm over here stretching myself and hoping I don't have to go in, though.
They might call you. And I heard you started as a quarterback, then got switched to wide receiver. How'd that turn out?
It turned out pretty good. You know, 2 years of quarterback at Tulsa, and then I begged for the opportunity to move me to wide receiver, and they did, because I wanted to play pro ball, and that turned out pretty good for me.
Absolutely. Thanks, Drew.
All right. Thank you.
Dave, he is a lot of fun to talk to. We've been watching this game together, and he is everything he just said, as fired up, running around, calling plays. He's having a great time.
But I got a problem. You don't go from quarterback to wide receiver, Drew. Come on.
That's coming from a quarterback, though, folks. Richard Sincere in at quarterback. And he will be wrestled to the ground at the 28-yard line. Picks up 9. Carlton Littlejohn with his 5th tackle this afternoon.
With the play call coming up right now, you see Brian Bell coming into the game. In the last series, we saw his knee was banged up. Got to closely monitor that and see if they just eliminate the running game when Bell comes into the game, and do they throw the ball with him, or at least eliminate the option portion of the run.
Here's the pistol formation. Flanders, your tailback. Couple of tight ends on second down and short. A lot of options here for Sam Houston State. They'll just try to keep it with Bell, and he'll fall forward over the 30 and pick up the first down. So a fresh set of downs coming up for the Bearcats.
And that didn't look like a very strong cut by Brian Bell. You can tell he's affected by it a little bit, still trying to tough it out, but that wasn't a very sharp move there from a quarterback that's pretty elusive running the football.
5 carries, 24 yards on the ground for Bell. Yeah, he's just not moving around like he was the first couple of possessions of this game. Sincere will come in motion to the near side. Bell looking to throw, lost it up for Flanders. He has it down to the 35-yard line. Andre Martin will throw him to the turf, but not before 33 yards for the Bearcats.
Well, we mentioned it, when you're playing an option team, it's all about assignment football. Take a look at the linebacker core peeking in the backfield at the quarterback, and they just lose sight of where Flanders is. 3 linebackers do not recognize Flanders. Easy throw and catch, big play, and you can tell there, North Dakota State on that play did not pass their assignment grade.
12th catch of the year for Flanders out of the backfield. First down and 10. Bell will throw it. Pass caught on the far side. Chance Nelson, a transfer from Texas A&M out of Baytown, Texas, picks up 9 yards, brought down by Marcus Williams.
Chance Nelson was quite a discovery for this football team. They didn't anticipate much from him when he transferred there from Texas A&M, but all they've gotten is a wide receiver that's averaged 20 yards per catch throughout the season, and
He's been their go-to deep threat time and time again.
How good has he been? 33 catches on the year. 9 of them have gone for scores. On second down, here's Flanders trying to work his magic to the outside. And a flag comes in. Shane Young, tied in, threw his arms up in the air. Let's see if they didn't get him for a hold on Easley Thornton.
Holding. Offense, number 89. 10-yard penalty. Before you fall the foul. Still, first down.
Yeah, and this is one you're going to see. He's your tight end there. We know that the ball is going to be bounced to the outside. How was it open there? One-on-one, he's got him engaged. Then when Flanders bounces to the outside, Martin does a good job of selling it as well. That wasn't a clear-cut hold. But when those hands get outside on the shoulder pad so often, the officials call that.
Sincere. Back in at quarterback. Number 6, he's got Flanders behind him. Sincere looking to throw, but he is dropped at the 41. Kyle Emanuel, the defensive end, picks up his 5th sack of the year and a loss of 9.
Well, they went with the misdirection, and you're going to see Kyle Emanuel do a good job just beating his man. This is Emanuel over here. He takes a great angle to the quarterback. Able to go hard to the outside, puts the speed on the tackle, Daniel Jenkins. Sincere thinks he has more time to throw the ball than he actually does. Big play by Kyle Emanuel.
Coaches say he has outstanding speed. A former middle linebacker moved to defensive end. 4-man rush. Bell to throw over the middle. Batted in the air and almost fell into the hands of Torrance Williams. But it looked like there might have been some contact before the ball got there.
Looked like there was plenty of contact before that ball got there. Trying to get the ball to Torrance Williams. And you're going to see when the ball's in the air, it gets away from him a little bit, trying to get into Chance Nelson. And he got hit by Andre Martin well before the ball got there.
And it went off his face mask as he was hit from behind by Martin. And now you're looking at a 4th down situation. Play clock down to 4. Matt Foster trying to pooch one inside the 10-yard line. Ryan Smith will let it hit at the goal line. And Foster does his job. The ball is down at the 6, a 35-yard punt. But I think North Dakota State got away with one there. The Bison offense back on the field when we come back. They are backed up in the shadows of the goalpost.
Across thousands of cities and millions of miles, T-Mobile's nationwide 4G network has the U.S. covered from coast to coast. Nationwide 4G coverage from T-Mobile, reaching over 220 million Americans. See for yourself at T-Mobile.com.
Are you ready to save up to 95% on what you want most? Then try Quibids.com, an exciting new way to shop for products like iPads, MacBooks, HDTVs, cameras, appliances, and more. Imagine getting a new Apple iPad today for just $23.74.
I'm Brian, and I've won over 30 products and saved over $7,000 on Quibids.com, the best place to get amazing deals online.
That's Quibids.com. Go to Quibids.com now.
NCAA FCS Football Championship is presented by
Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. And in part by Toyota Scion. See your local Scion dealer.
He's in, but he lifted up.
Boy, it's been a great atmosphere here in Frisco, Texas. Standing room only for the FCS National Championship game. North Dakota State, Sam Houston State. A rematch of the title game a year ago. Fourth meeting between these two teams. North Dakota State holds a 2-1 advantage in that department. Boy, John Crockett had a 57-yard run. He has amassed 64 yards on the ground. It has been a struggle for North Dakota State's offense. Remember, Sam Houston State's only given up 20 points per game, but they've played two of the most high-powered offenses in the FBS in Baylor and Texas A&M this year. That handoff. 2-0 Jury will net them a couple of yards. Yeah, those defensive numbers from Sam Houston State can be a little skewed with that 20 points per game, and that also includes the semifinal game when they gave up 42 in the second half to Eastern Washington, a game you saw.
Yeah, and just to tell you what it was, before that game, they averaged only giving up 15 points a game. The Eastern Washington put 42 on them, crept that number up to 20 points per game, but this is still a very stingy defense, and they just don't allow you to run the football, and they play great man-to-man coverage.
Jensen out of the end zone, going up top, looking for Smith into double coverage. It's incomplete, and now you're looking at third down, and let's say eight.
And what you have to do as a quarterback when you're taking on a team that's going to play so much man-to-man coverage, you've got to be very accurate, because that window to get the ball there is not as wide open as if a team is playing zone coverage. And when you've got guys that can run, getting those crossing patterns has got to be thrown on the money, or else a defensive secondary like Sam Houston, that has 16 interceptions by their secondary alone, will make you pay.
Pressure comes. Jensen avoids the tackle. Incomplete. Kenneth Jenkins came on a safety blitz and almost had Jensen for a safety in the end zone.
See, realizing they were seizing control of the line of scrimmage and had the ability to cover the wide receivers man-to-man, they're going to bring Jenkins. You see Jenkins come right in here in a good angle, but good athleticism by Jensen to get away from the pocket, from the blitzer. Would have been a safety and threw the ball away.
Ben LeCompte will punt to Trey Diller. Diller stands at midfield. That kick will hit at the 46 and take a Sam Houston bounce. Boy, some outstanding field position again for Sam Houston State. They will officially mark it at the 45-yard line, so a short field for the Bearcats and Brian Bell. Well, two of the most storied programs in college football collide Monday night in the Discover BCS National Championship. Manti Te'o and the Notre Dame Fighting Irish look to secure their first national title since 1988. A.J. McCarron has the Alabama Crimson Tide on track for their third title in 4 years. It's the Discover BCS National Championship. Number one, Notre Dame. Number two, Alabama. Coverage starts Monday at 8 Eastern on ESPN. Also live on Watch ESPN. We've got a title game ourselves right here. Sam Houston State hand off to Flanders, trying to sidestep through the line of scrimmage. Can't get past Little John, who's having a nice afternoon with six stops. But there are some of the particulars between Notre Dame and Alabama.
And much like this game here, Notre Dame, number one team in the country. You see they only average allowing 10 points per game. Defense, clearly, if you've got a stout defense, you can play for championships in the college football landscape of today's world.
Second down and eight. Bell lofts it up. Williams with the interception. The All-American making a play. He is dropped at the 28-yard line by Trey Diller. But for Marcus Williams, his sixth interception of the season and his 17th of his career to take over the top spot in the record books at North Dakota State.
This is a playmaker making a big play on a big stage. Marcus Williams, man-to-man cut. He sees the ball. Watch him adjust. Go up and get it at its highest point. Win that battle, a jump ball, and then become a running back after he gets it. But did not allow the ball to come to him. Elevated, and then became a return man and picked up some extra yards after the interception to help jumpstart this offensive unit for the Bison.
17 career interceptions for the Missouri Valley Defensive Player of the Year. And he sets up his offense at the 27 and a half yard line. Here is Smith on a little receiver end around. Gets a couple of yards as he goes flying into his Bison bench.
North Dakota State continuing to respect the interior defensive linemen for Sam Houston. Most of the running plays we've seen by North Dakota State have been running to the perimeter, attack the perimeter. Very rarely have we seen them run downhill and try and just control the line of scrimmage.
Couple of tight ends in the game. High formation for North Dakota State. That pass caught right in front of Bookie Snead. Trevor Gebhardt with the grab. He is slammed to the ground. 6 yard pickup. They'll make it third down and about 3.5. The Bison, 1 out of 6 on third downs. They came in 51%, fifth best in the FCS. Jensen trying to run for it. He will have it. And then some to the 43-yard line, and he's dropped there. And it looks as though Darnell Taylor is injured on the far side of the field. The team's leading tackle, an All-American.
Whoa. This is one here. One of the things that you do with this formation here, when they come out in this bunch formation on both sides, that makes it hard to play man-to-man coverage. So they made the adjustment to go to zone coverage. When they got zone coverage, everybody's trying to run the space. Nowhere to go, and you'll see, wow, the play wasn't even there when Darnell Taylor went down on the sideline holding on to his knee, and that would be a devastating blow for the Bearcats, considering 100 tackles on the season, their leading tackler and conference defensive player of the year, not once but twice. He's the reason they're able to do so many things with their defense in terms of playing man-to-man coverage. Coming up on the right side. By the time Jensen runs past him, Taylor had already been down on the ground.
It just looked like that knee buckled on him. Of course, his twin brother, Darius Taylor, middle linebacker for this team, but Darnell leads him with 100 tackles. Matter of fact, 233 solo tackles in his career is a Sam Houston State school record. There's his brother Darius making his way to check on his brother. Darius goes 240, Darnell 195. You know, the coaches were telling us it's not, those guys, a lot of twins will finish each other's statements, you know, wear the same clothes, but not so much with those guys. They're more like older brother, little brother type siblings.
Yeah, that's what they said. They're twins. You know, but they're brothers first. You know, they play off of each other. And Darius playing the linebacker position, very physical, gets in your face. Darnell's a guy that just gets his job done all the time. And it'll be interesting to see how Darius will make the adjustment with Darnell out of the game. And physically, you can tell, you, if you look close enough, you can tell they look alike. You know, you can just tell there's an extra 50 pounds on Darius because of the position that he plays.
Two outstanding football players in their final game with Sam Houston State. And we certainly hope Darnell will be okay as he is attended to on that Sam Houston State sideline. So first down and 10 for North Dakota State. They keep the drive alive. Here comes Smith near side, gets a nice block. He's to the 30, he's to the 20, and dropped there. They will spot it at the 20-yard line. A big gainer again. This one goes for 24 after the 21-yard pickup a moment ago.
They want to continue to run on the jet sweep, attack the perimeter, see if they can make plays in space. Good downfield blocking, and great vision by Ryan Smith.
Jay, Ryan Smith in the semifinal game had a bad cap. Didn't even know if he was going to play. And these 3 weeks off between the semis and this national title game have certainly helped him. He looks really fast today. Three rushes, 29 yards. Jensen has it to the 10. He cuts it back. He will take it in. Touchdown, North Dakota State from 20 yards out. Set up by the interception from Marcus Williams. North Dakota State, the first touchdown of the game. Adam Keller in to attempt the point after. And he will split the uprights. 72 yards. Three of those five plays went for over 20. The last one by Jensen.
To me, I'll give it to you. I know what you want. You know I got it.
Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you. As long as you want.
You're watching the NCAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. North Dakota State just put a touchdown on the board, and it came off what appeared to be almost like a broken play, was it?
It seems to be a broken play by Brock Jensen, but when that happens, you've got to go to the last line of defense. And take a look here on the spotlight. You're going to see Mike Littleton, who came in to replace Darnell Taylor, who went out with an injury. When Jensen gets across line of scrimmage, you got to make that tackle right there. Once Mike Littleton misses that tackle, he's the last line of defense. Touchdown for North Dakota State.
It looked as though John Crockett might have gone the other way, and Jensen was trying to hand it off to him, and he decided to run with it as you look at the injured Darnell Taylor. And by the way he looks, it may be the end of his Bearcat career, the way he has his head down. Phil will take a knee. Time for us to head to our studios and get an update.
All right, thanks, Dave. Steve Weissman in studio, and coming up at halftime, it could be a long day for Pitt fans. Already got upset in hoops, and now Ole Miss with an aerial assault in the BBVA Compass Bowl. Plus, 2 days until the BCS national title game. We'll get you updated with a report from South Florida, and Duke's Quinn Cook with a very rare stat line. We'll tell you what he did today in the Blue Devils game. That's at the half. Now back to Texas.
Thanks, Steve. Sam Houston State. We'll have 3:09 to work with. Sincere in at quarterback. Low snap, good hands by Sincere. Stays on his feet and then just walloped after a gain of a couple on the play. Boy, the Bison really throwing themselves at the football right now defensively. Cole Jurek, the first man there. Grant Olson comes in. He could pick a couple other guys as well in on that tackle. Olson now with four stops today.
Active around the football, that's what they've got to do. And right now, Sam Houston State needs to figure out the riddle, which is this North Dakota State defense. They only scored 6 points a season ago, only 3 points today. They've been out of sync. They've moved the football several times, but they've not been able to consistently maintain a scoring drive yet.
Bell will throw. And near side to Trey Diller. He'll pick up the first down at the 37. Marcus Williams on the coverage.
And that's something that North Dakota State will do. They will play soft zone coverage until you cross midfield. So you'll see guys like Marcus Williams and Andre Martin giving up the things in front of them, coming up and making the tackle. Then the moment you try and go deep, Marcus Williams shows up and makes an interception or creates some type of turnover.
Brian Bell today, 7 out of 12, 110 yards. That pass caught by Sincere out over the 40 to the 44-yard line, a 7-yard pickup. Working on Marcus Williams. Clock goes to 1:38. Three timeouts remaining for both teams here in the second quarter. Bell checks out. Sincere back in at quarterback. Sincere tried to throw one earlier but was sacked by Cole Jurek. Flanders, out over the 45 to the 47. Mike Hardy with the tackle. That'll be close to the first down. They will move the chains.
Once again, Tim Flanders showing you why he's a special running back. No place to run the football, but he still managed to be an effective runner and pick up the first down.
Bell to throw. It's Williams. He's run out of bounds, a yard shy of the first down, but that'll stop the clock at 1:04. Brian Shepard back on the field. Brian has missed some time, had a lacerated kidney. Missed about 9 weeks, has number 24 for North Dakota State. Williams has also missed some time with a cut knee. Torrance back on the field has had one of those injuries right on his kneecap where the cut couldn't heal, and he's missed about half the season. Over the middle, it's picked off. Andre Martin with the interception. And he is dropped back at the 44-yard line. A flag down back at the 22-yard line. Brian Bell moves the ball all the way down to the 30. Saying it's against North Dakota State.
Number 8, an eligible receiver. 3-yard penalty, turns automatic, first down.
So they actually called the hold on Andre Martin, who had the interception. He did it. Seemed as if he undercut the route right here. This is that matchup you want to look for right here. That's that one-on-one coverage, and you're going to see him come underneath the route. Ooh. Oh. I mean, that's a tough one. This is a poorly thrown ball. Great anticipation by Martin coming underneath. Almost looked as if he was the intended target. I think Sam Houston caught a huge break on that call.
Bearcats will swing it out to Torrance Williams. And he will get it close to the 30-yard line, gain of 4. And the clock will stop at 48 seconds. There is Torrance Williams, electrifying performer. But only played in 6 games this year, caught 33 passes a year ago. And perhaps the fastest guy they have on offense. Little dump off. Flanders can't hang on to it. Incomplete. Boy, pressure came, and Bell had to get rid of that rather quickly as he continues to hobble down.
Yeah, Kyrie Manuel, number 53, getting there. They both get licks on the quarterback. Both defensive end, that's Cole Jarek and Kyle Emanuel. One of those things that's been probably the point of concern for Sam Houston, their offensive line's been banged up, really got beat up in that game versus Eastern Washington, and now you've got Daniel Jenkins starting. Kyle Hobson is out of the game.
Pressure comes. Bell lofts it up. Looking for Sincere. Has it. He's at the 5. Down to the 1. Andre Martin on the coverage. First and goal, Sam Houston State with 37 seconds to play after a 30-yard pickup.
What a tremendous throw by Brian Bell. That's anticipation, knowing that you're going to get hit in the pocket, standing tall. Cole Jarrett bringing pressure again. You're going to see number 93 is going to bring pressure again, but you got to know your matchup. He knows that I've got one-on-one on the outside, hang it in the air, put some air underneath it, allow Sincere to run underneath the ball, readjust. That's a big-time play by Brian Bell. That's how you play the quarterback position.
Bell earlier in this game on a quarterback run had his right leg caught up underneath him on a tackle and really looked awkward, had it leave the game for a couple of plays, got it taped up, and has been limping around ever since, but made a solid throw there. First and goal now for the Bearcats. Let's go downstairs, check in with Kara.
Well, Dave, shortly after Brian Bell got his right ankle taped up in another break, he had his left ankle taped up for good measure. Very physical brand of football from North Dakota State. They're taking every precaution to protect number 11.
So Bell will bring those taped ankles out to the field in a three tight end set now on first and goal from the one. Bell to loft it up. Pass caught. Touchdown. Sam Houston State from a yard out. K.J. Williams, the senior out of Norman, Oklahoma, makes the catch. Point after, up and good. The fifth catch of the year for KJ, his third touchdown reception. And Sam Houston State has tied it up, 33 seconds left.
You focus on Timothy Flanders, the running back, as you should, but it looks right here as if he's going to block, but he does a great job of taking it to the back of the end zone, slip behind the linebacker. It's almost like a little tight end slip screen, all sold because you've got Timothy Flanders in the backfield. Great touch by Brian Bell throwing over the defense.
Brian Bell with his 25th passing touchdown of the season against just 7 interceptions, 9 plays, 75 yards, 2.5 minutes off the clock.
And during that last drive, that was quarterbacking at a very high championship caliber level. That's what you want. He showed it all there. What I really like is once you anticipate what the defense is going to do to you, you can attack. We know right now he's lost his mobility for this game, so he's relying upon his mental toughness, his mental aptitude, and his right arm to make plays for the Bearcats.
So Miguel Antonio will kick it away. Marcus Williams and Ryan Smith won't have a chance as this is a short kick. To Andrew Grothman, the fullback, will take it, and he'll be stopped at the 36-yard line. The NCAA championships continue with the Indoor Track and Field Championship. Coverage begins Sunday, March 17th at 7 o'clock Eastern on ESPNU. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 89 NCAA championships. Well, let's see what Craig Bohl decides to step on the gas here with 3 timeouts, 30 seconds left. They'll have a 3 receiver set to the right. Sam Ojuri in at tailback. Jensen dumps it off underneath. Pass is caught by Andrew Oakland and he gets out of bounds after a gain of 9. 22 seconds left before halftime.
And right now, this is the confidence that they have in Brock Jensen as a leader. Realizing tie ball game, less than a minute, half a minute to go in the half. They trust him not to turn over the football. Only make the sure throw if somebody comes wide open. If it's not there, just get rid of it.
Anderson dropped at the 47. He will fall forward for a yard. That'll be close to the first down. 14 seconds left to go before halftime. North Dakota State wants a timeout.
Timeout, North Dakota State.
There is Darnell Taylor making that slow journey back to the Sam Houston State locker room, the team's leading tackler, two-time Southland Conference Defensive Player of the Year. That is a big-time loss for the Bearcats.
That's a tough one there, seeing Darnell Taylor there. You know, in a game like this, you want everybody to bring their best game forward, but you got to make the adjustment now. A lot more falls on the shoulders of his twin brother right there, number 36, Darius Taylor, to step up, make a play.
Jensen will be dropped back at the 38. Andrew Weaver with his fifth sack of the year, All-American defensive end.
With that sack, you should make this the end of the half. Good move on the stunt by Andrew Weaver. He's lined up on the left side, came up the middle of the defense on the stunt, got the sack, and I think that may be one of the final plays for North Dakota State offensively of the first half.
North Dakota State took a timeout. Craig Bohl unhappy with the way this sequence has gone the past few seconds.
And I think right now, considering you've got a 10-10 tie, less than 9 seconds, right at 9 seconds, I would just be content to run out the clock. But they're coming out in what seems to be a pass formation. You've got to be very careful with your ball security in these type of situations.
Jensen to throw again. Did Smith make the catch? Yes, he did. Whoa. Down at the 33-yard line as he backpedaled toward the sideline, a pickup of 28. And now you have 2 seconds left. North Dakota State will take another timeout, their final.
And Jensen threw this ball in a very small window. Yes. He managed to get the right leg down. Wow, great throw. Tremendous concentration by Ryan Smith to make the catch, and that right foot is down before the left comes down out of bounds. You see there, and that's one where you've got a team that plays so much man-to-man defense in Sam Houston that when the situation and the down and distance requires zone coverage, they struggle at times. That's what got them in trouble versus Eastern Washington in their semifinal victory in the second half. In this case here, giving up a huge play before the half, allowing North Dakota State to attempt a field goal to try and take the lead going into halftime.
Well, here's Adam Keller, a 50-yard attempt. He has not attempted any over 50 yards this year. His long, though, is 49. And now Sam Houston State wants a timeout. Jay, what do you think? I mean, is there anything to this icing the kicker? You see it so often. Is there anything to it?
Well, I say this. You know, kickers are a different breed. And anybody that's been in the locker room would say they're a different breed. And anytime you can make them think about something other than putting the ball through the uprights, I think you have to do it. And I think mental toughness is measured with kickers, and that's something that you normally don't associate with most average kickers. When you get those tough, mentally tough kickers, they're like nails. They're some of the toughest people you'll meet in life. So,
Will Keller is a first-team All-Missouri Valley kicker. As we mentioned, set the school record for field goals made this year with 17. Has one from 32 today. So we'll try it again from 50 yards out. Far hash mark. Michael Murphy to snap. Ben LeCompte, the punter, to hold. That is well short, and it's fielded by Dak Swanson in the end zone. The old school football, but he is dropped. And there goes some flags. Boy, and Craig Bowl has given his kicker an earful.
And pretty hard to do that because he's such a laid-back person with his demeanor, but he's typical, speak softly and carry a big stick. Well, he's not speaking softly right now to Adam Keller. You hate to see flags fly in such a well-played, highly fought first half of football for the championship.
After the play was over, we have two dead ball personal fouls against Sam Houston. Those penalties, number 66 and 32. Those penalties will be enforced on the second half kickoff. Halftime.
Gary Laurence and Kenneth Jenkins hit with those personal fouls on the way into the locker room, but we are tied at 10 as the end result after 30 minutes of football. Last year, Sam Houston State led 6-3 at the break. But North Dakota State would score 14 in the second half to win. Let's go downstairs, visit with Carol.
Coach, animated conversation there with kicker Adam Keller. What was that about?
Well, he missed the kick, and we just got to have him work on it better.
What other adjustments do the Bison need to make?
Well, we got to do a better job. They're doing a nice job throwing the football. We knew they were going to make progress in it, but they're going to take their shots, and we got to make them pay for it.
You told us it was going to be close. How does this compare to your expectations?
This is exactly what we thought. I'm sure Coach Fritz will say the same thing. Great ball game.
Thank you, Coach. Dave?
Thanks, Kara. Craig Bowl won this a year ago. Oh, FCS National Coach of the Year. His club tied up with Sam Houston State. They're your defending national champs. Let's head to the studios.
All right, thanks, guys. Halfway through one national championship and just 2 days from another. Welcome into the Halftime Studios. I'm Steve Weissman. We will have a preview of the BCS national title game from South Florida. Plus, Andy Katz will join me to break down some college basketball from earlier today. And, of course, we start with another bowl game, the last one for Ole Miss and Pitt. Could be considered a second bowl game for the Rebels. Of course, they beat Mississippi State in the Egg Bowl. Hugh Freeze and company taking on Pittsburgh. This one over on ESPN. Scoreless in the first. Pitt driving Tino Sinceri. Picked off by Cinquez Golson. Ensuing possession, Bo Wallace going to work. The sophomore from Tennessee. To Jamez Logan. 14 yards. Ole Miss up 7-0. And they'll be screaming hottie toddy at the Grove after they see this. Wallace to Randall McKay. 27 yards. Wallace started this game 8 of 8, 64 yards, 2 touchdowns. Back comes Pitt. Sunseri on the run. Finds Devin Street, 10-yard touchdown, so they cut the deficit in half, but old hottie toddy coming back. Bo Wallace hooking up with Vince Sanders. Oh, spin move me. Wallace 14-20, 104 and 3 touchdowns. It's 24-10 Ole Miss at the half. Meanwhile, the legend of Johnny Football grew larger last night. Texas A&M taking on Oklahoma in the Cotton Bowl, scoreless in the first. Manziel rolls to his left, somehow gets away. A little water bug out there. 23 yards, tiptoeing to the end zone. He rushed for a bowl record 229. Fourth quarter, Texas A&M up 34-13. Manziel, he could do it through the air as well. Uzoma Wachuku finished with a bowl record 516 total yards. Aggies win the Cotton Bowl 41-13. Was the final. Well, here's a look at the latest conference tote board for the bowl season. Texas A&M's win in the Cotton Bowl bumped the SEC above 500 thus far. Ole Miss, Alabama, still yet to play, and Oklahoma and the Big 12 finished the bowl season at 4-5. Well, we are just 2 days until the BCS National Championship. A report from South Florida on the way. Don't go anywhere.
NCAA.com is your online destination for college sports. With comprehensive video highlights and editorial coverage of FCS, Division II and Division III football playoffs, along with soccer, volleyball, cross-country, and field hockey championships across all three divisions, NCAA.com has extensive coverage of your favorite schools and your favorite sports this fall. NCAA.com, the home of college sports.
How's the weather up there? It's okay here. Forecast calls for more of the same. Blue skies, beaches, $300,000 cars. All day and all night. Miami's ready for the BCS National Championship game. Are you? Come south for the winter.
Well, we've waited 127 days for the BCS National Championship game, so what's two more? Well, it could be two more days of distractions on South Beach. Notre Dame coach Brian Kelly has a strict 11 p.m. curfew for his team. Remarkable, that number actually greater than the amount of touchdowns his defense has allowed all season. As for Alabama, there's much talk about the hotel they've chosen to stay at. The Fountain Blue Miami Beach, on its website listing 24/7 glamour and romance. But it also mentions legacy. And if the Tide could win the title for the third time in the last 4 years, that's what we'll be talking about. Here's Reese Davis with more.
If you speak Spanish, stand at a Cuban coffee counter and you'll hear a pure window into the collective mind of Little Havana. If you don't speak Spanish, just count the number of times someone says Fidel. This is Miami.
You can find a nice cup of coffee, a little stroll through Little Havana where the people mingle and there's a nice, easy vibe down there. The music kind of gives you a free-flowing feel, but it's going to pick up in intensity on Monday night in the BCS Discover National Championship game between Notre Dame and Alabama. Alabama won the national championship last year, but don't call them defending champions. There's no such thing. Those who aspire to be champions pursue each and every season. Each season, each play has a life and a history of its own. That's the type of mental conditioning that Nick Saban seeks to instill in his team. So if you're going to talk about Alabama, you can say maybe they're trying to, what's that word mean, to do over or do it again, reproduce an event, you know, repeat.
We just haven't thought at all about, you know, that word. I'm not going to say it. You know, he hasn't said it, so I'm not going
to
say it.
There's no reason to repeat. It's a whole another season. The champion's crowned at the end of the season, so it doesn't matter what you won the year before.
I guess it's just his way of getting everybody to go out and play like it's our first time ever being on that stage.
You start thinking about all the external factors and you lose sight of, you know, what's important, which is just preparation for the game.
You know, it's not about really a legacy or a dynasty or any of that, those words. It's about this year, 2012, being the best team.
You know why it's an unspoken mission? Because nobody's spoken about it. It hasn't been done. Reigning BCS champions to return to the title game, they haven't fared very well. In 2000, Florida State looked awful, losing to Oklahoma. The other two games, though, classics between Miami and Ohio State and USC and Texas. Alabama takes its shot against Notre Dame on Monday night. Jesse Palmer, David Pollack here. So, how about an under-the-radar difference maker in this game?
Offensive linemen never get the spotlight, but I got my eye on left guard Chance Wormack for Alabama. He will be the best player on the field Monday night. He's the best offensive lineman in the entire country. Big, physical, can create movement, climb into the second level on linebackers and safeties. He can pass block. This guy ends people when you put the tape on. His matchups against Lewis Nix III, Stephon Tuitt, and Manti Te'o in this game are going to be epic. We know that Alabama has to be able to run the football to have success offensively. Chance Wormack's going to have to play well. If he plays well, Alabama can win this game.
My favorite thing about him is his Twitter handle, or his Twitter, his belly has a Twitter account.
I mean, that's what's outstanding about him. He keeps the shirt cut up to here. But another guy to look at is Amari Cooper. He's a guy that's come on late. Once he really got healthy and ingrained in this offense, watch him go up and get it. I mean, go up over top people, run by people, really started clicking the last few weeks of the season. Warmack protects him. Eddie Lacy runs the football. Yeldon runs the football. But guess what? If you don't double cover him, he will murder you down the field. This guy right here is a huge matchup problem for Notre Dame. They're going to run the football, but when they pass it, they'll take shots to number nine.
You know, everybody keeps saying that that's where the weak link is for Notre Dame, and nobody's been able to exploit it. Now, maybe that's because the front seven's been so good. We'll see how the matchup goes. That's the matchup that's gotten a lot of attention in the days leading up to the Discover BCS National Championship game. Alabama and Notre Dame, we're closing in on it. Wall-to-wall coverage, college football live, Sports Center, college game day, you name it. It'll be there on Monday night when the Tide and the Fighting Irish square off.
All right, thanks, fellas. Some other news, Brett McMurphy reporting Alabama senior defensive end Quentin Dial will not miss any playing time Monday for his hit on Georgia quarterback Aaron Murray in last month's SEC title game. Of course, Alabama, Notre Dame in the national championship game on ESPN Monday night. Well, the Notre Dame football team, not the only one playing. The Irish open up Big East basketball play today, looking for their 17th straight win at home. Andy Katz joins next.
The boys use Capital One Venture Miles for their annual football trip. That's double miles you can actually use. Tragically, their buddy got sacked by blackouts.
But it's our tradition.
That's roughing the card holder.
But with the Capital One Venture card, you get double miles you can actually use. Any fright? Any time.
Scoreboard doesn't lie.
What's in your wallet? Hut! I have me on my fantasy team.
This year, share everything. Share brotherly love. Share one-ups.
Mom?
The Share Everything plan lets your family share a pool of data across 10 devices with unlimited talk and text.
Now get a Lucid by LG free.
We all make bad decisions, like, say, gas station sushi. Cheap is good, and sushi, good. But cheap sushi, not so good. It's like that super low rate on not enough car insurance. Pretty sketchy. And then there are the good decisions, like eSurance. Their coverage counselor tool helps you choose the right coverage for you at a great price, without feeling queasy. That's insurance for the modern world. eSurance, now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
NCAA.com/shop has all the hottest officially licensed 2012 championship merchandise. With over 100,000 items for over 500 college teams, everything you need is in one location. You'll get 365-day hassle-free returns, great customer service, and $4.99 three-day shipping on any size order. Remember, for all your college gear, head to ncaa.com/shop.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NCAA for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or any picture, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NCAA's consent is prohibited.
Fighting Irish have finished an undefeated regular season, and now they will head to Miami.
The final seconds will tick away here in South Bend. The Irish with an impressive win over Kentucky.
It's going to be a golden day for Golden Domers on Monday. We got hoops at 6:30 Eastern on ESPN2, then the BCS National Title Game, 8 Eastern on ESPN, Notre Dame and Alabama. Steve Weissman, Andy Katz, we will be at halftime of the
right
hoops
here.
Game. Yeah, that's
if
right.
If you're an Irish fan, make sure you're watching that Notre Dame-Cincinnati game before you start watching this Alabama game.
And here's a little preview of what to see from Notre Dame's hoops team playing today, being overshadowed by the football team, but they're one of the hottest hoops teams in the country right now, Mike Bray and company.
Especially at home. They've got great balance with this Irish team. You've got Jack Cooley, Scott Martin, Eric Atkins, Jaren Grant. They can hit you in all different ways.
There's Atkins, 17 points, 10 dimes, early second half. How about Scott Martin, six-year senior, had six threes.
And he's making the most of this extra season. Remember, he was hurt. He transferred from Purdue. become an effective leader for the Irish.
A season high 22 points. Notre Dame wins their 11th straight win for the Irish. Meanwhile, earlier today on ESPN2, Pitt and Rutgers. Jamie Dixon didn't expect this. First half, Eli Carter was playing well for the Scarlet Knights.
Showing that Jimmer range for Rutgers. This was a must win for Mike Rice. Remember, he was suspended 3 games for his behavior, fined $50,000. They lost in his comeback to Syracuse, wins this home game.
Pitt making a game of it, but in the end, more Eli Carter, a game-high 23 points. Their first home win against Pitt since 2001. Panthers have Georgetown next.
Ooh, could be 0-3.
Could be 0-3 indeed. How about Coach K and Duke hosting Wake Forest? Duke looking to start 14-0 for the second time in the last 3 years. About 6.5 minutes left in the half. Ryan Kelly, he averages 8 points against all other ACC opponents, 21 against Wake.
Yeah, they served up Wake Forest, the worst team in the ACC for the best team. But I'll tell you, what a line coming up. We're going to segue here for Quinn Cook. Maybe one of the more bizarre point guard lines we've seen.
That was Seth Curry for three. He's two away from 1,000 for his Duke career. And here's Quinn Cook. One thing he did today was drop dimes, 14 of them, a career high. Duke wins 80-62. And you mentioned that stat line. Check this out. Finished the game with a career-high 14 assists, but didn't make a shot. 0 for 12 from the field, Andy.
14 assists, 2 turnovers, but he has been the stabilizing presence for this team. The big question going into the season was who was going to play the point. It is Quinn Cook. It allows Seth Curry to do what he does best, which is make shots.
You'd like him to make something, though. 0 for 12.
Against Wake, it didn't matter.
We got a couple of ranked teams. Number 11 Illinois hosting number 8 Ohio State. This was your favorite matchup of the day.
Really, John Gross, who worked for Thad Mata, knows this team very well after a disappointing road loss to Purdue. But right now, Illinois is clicking on all cylinders, as even though they didn't defend that shot as well, but how can you? That's from Jimmer range as well.
Brandon Paul, and then later, we got Abrams and Brandon Paul. Illinois up 7. Brandon Paul, he can dish as well. Joseph Bertrand.
Remember, Brandon Paul was sensational in what I think will go down as one of the best non-conference road wins of the year when Illinois won at Gonzaga.
So Illinois up 37-21 now on the Buckeyes late in the first half. A couple other games going on. Michigan State, it was close early, but pulled it out against Purdue. And then what are you seeing from this game, Kansas State, Oklahoma State?
Well, first of all, for Oklahoma State, Marcus Smart now has 3 personal fouls. That could be key going down the stretch here. Very critical home game for K-State. Oklahoma State has been one of the undervalued teams so far this season. They're a quality club.
2-point game right now. You can catch it on ESPN3 and our favorite app, Watch ESPN. Well, after winning the Fiesta Bowl, it's been an NFL party for Oregon coach Chip Kelly. Find out what team is interviewing him today. That's next. Don't go anywhere.
DiGiorno or delivery? DiGiorno or delivery? DiGiorno. Taste for yourself why the shortest distance between you and a delicious fresh-baked pizza is your oven. 100% real cheese. Amazing toppings. Thankfully, it's not delivery. It's DiGiorno. Nestle, good food, good life.
Division I student athletes have higher SAT and ACT scores than college-bound students.
The number of us receiving diplomas
is at an all-time high.
African-American males who are student athletes
are 10% more likely to graduate.
Still think we're just a bunch of dumb jocks?
You need to do your homework.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Back on the halftime report, Eagles scheduled to meet with Chip Kelly today, according to sources. On Friday, Kelly interviewed for 5 hours with Browns owner Jim Haslam and CEO Joe Banner. Kelly, of course, coming off a Fiesta Bowl win for Oregon, he has also interviewed with the Buffalo Bills. Elsewhere in the sports world, a Panthers spokesman said that head coach Ron Rivera met with owner Jerry Richardson earlier today, and he'll return for his 3rd season with the team. Meanwhile, Mavs forward Dirk Nowitzki will make his first start of the season tonight against the Hornets. And face-to-face labor talks resumed today in the NHL lockout. The two sides hadn't met since Thursday. Speaking of hockey, World Junior Championships, U.S. and Sweden. How about Rocco Grimaldi? Plays his college hockey at North Dakota. He had 2 goals today as the U.S. wins the title for the 3rd time. They won in 04, 2010. Do you believe in miracles, Andy Katz?
Oh, come on. You're dating yourself. You're going to throw that one out there.
We did it. Time for you to bump us out.
North Dakota State, not just about football, in basketball. The Bison knocked off rival South Dakota State earlier. Saul Phillips getting it done for the Bison.
Just diagramming this accident with my State Farm Pocket Agent app. You can also get a quote and pay your premium with this thing.
I thought State Farm didn't have all those apps.
Where'd you hear that?
The internet.
And you believed it?
Yeah. They can't put anything on the internet that isn't true.
Where'd you hear that?
The internet. Oh, look. Here comes my date. I met him on the internet. He's a French model.
Bonjour.
State Farm. More mobile than ever. Get to a better state.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student-athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
I think I'm about to break a string in here.
What they're playing for, the FCS National Championship Trophy. We're back in Frisco, just north of Dallas, Texas, tied at 10 after two quarters of football, moments away from third quarter action. Dave Neal alongside former NFL quarterback Jay Walker, and just to put it bluntly, any surprises in the first 30 minutes?
The fact that Sam Houston has controlled the football for five more minutes than North Dakota State. That's what North Dakota State makes their bread and butter off of, has not worked for them today. They're very fortunate to be tied in this football game.
Well, if you look at the numbers, very similar on both sides of the football. These teams pretty equally matched coming into this game, and well, the stats pretty much bear that out. 199 total yards for North Dakota State, 217 for Sam Houston.
Yeah, North Dakota State only 65 yards passing. Their game plan was to throw the football more than they have in the past. They've got to figure out a way to convert on third down. They've only had their 2 of 7 on third down conversion.
Well, after two personal fouls against Sam Houston State right before we went into the locker room, this is right. North Dakota State's going to kick it off from the 35, and they will pooch it, and I'm surprised they didn't try an onside kick it.
I mean, I would agree with you. Go for the onside kick. Even if they recover, they're still going to get the ball around the 25-yard line. But I think they did the exact opposite thing of what you want to do in that situation there, which is kick the ball to the end zone, and it's almost like the penalties were for naught.
Yeah, so Sam Houston State kind of dodges one there. Had they been the team kicking off, it would have been a dynamic change. They would have had to kick off from back near the 5-yard line, up from the 20-yard line.
Missed opportunity there. You know, take a chance for it. It's almost like a free chance at an onside kick.
So out of the pistol formation, Brian Bell with a bad ankle. Swings one near side. That pass is caught. Gain of a yard by Chance Nelson.
We've got to watch Brian Bell here during the second half. He tweaked his ankle in the first half. He's been able to tough it out, but so often when you go into the locker room at halftime, if you don't do a good job of keeping that ankle loose, it will tighten up on you. He's already limited mobility-wise now. We'll see how he does in the second half.
Bell lofts it up. Sincere was forced out of bounds. That's why the hat came flying in. Brian Shepard on the coverage. That'll give us an opportunity to visit with Kara.
I had a chance to visit with Sam Houston State head coach Willie Fritz. He told his players, be ready for a fourth quarter thriller. He acknowledged they made some mistakes they need to clean up, but he told us this week, guys, these Bearcats are very mature. They always respond. And their motto since losing in this national title game last year has been finish. We'll see if they can.
Third down and nine. He comes. Pass through the hands of Trey Diller. And flags come in. Late flags come in. Marcus Williams on the coverage of Diller. Williams already with an interception this afternoon that led to a North Dakota State touchdown.
Pass interference. Defense number one. Penalty enforcement. Spot a foul. Automatic first down.
Lee Williams matched up one-on-one here on the left side of your screen at the bottom, number one. And does he get there a little bit too soon on the slant route within that 5 yards? He's got that right arm draped against him, and the flag came from the official that was the only official that could see that arm draped around him. Touchy call, but when you've got the rules that favor offensive football as a defensive back, you've got to be extra careful not to get that arm draped around a wide receiver.
So on first and 10, Bell to throw again, lofts it up, looking for Williams to make a play, and he does at the 47. 19 yards.
Torrance Williams was going to be the secret weapon for Sam Houston. I don't think North Dakota State anticipated him participating in this football game. And you'll see a good job by Bell putting some air underneath the football. And Williams goes up and does the rest. Catches the ball with his hands, shielding off Christian Dudson.
Good catch by Williams, setting up his club at the 47-yard line. Flanders chased down at the 41. Brought down by Brian Shepard, a gain of 6, but that looked like it had a much bigger gain in it.
Well, he's an edge of your seat runner. I mean, watch the cut right here. Another cut right there, then bounce back to the outside. You're not going to tackle Timothy Flanders in open space. I mean, you've got the angle on when the safety comes up, and he puts a juke move on him. Picks up 6 yards on the play.
Look at that average, 3.1 per carry today. Came in averaging almost 6 yards a carry. Bell lofts it up. Overthrew Trey Diller. Boy, a lot of movement in the Sam Houston offense. They had a lot of movement a year ago. Changed offensive coordinators as Bob DeBess went to New Mexico. Work under Bob Davey, and they bring in Doug Roos, who was at Western Illinois and ran similar stuff, but they've brought more of a passing.
Still has a triple option concept, but it's different. Not more of the veer traditional option. This is more option reads on the edge and even options in the passing game.
Inside handoff. There goes Flanders. Give him 6. But a flag is down at the line of scrimmage.
Rolling. Offense number 74. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
The true freshman, Donald Jackson, with a hold at the line of scrimmage.
And you're going to see big Donald Jackson lining up at your guard position. This is Jackson right here. Trying to do a reach block over to his left. He's getting there. He's in good position. The takedown. And that's just a play where Flanders is by him. You know, the hold does not affect the play. He wasn't going to get there. There was somebody on the ground. But by definition, he was holding the jersey. They've got to call from behind.
That last angle gave you a good look. That left arm was definitely involved in that play. So now it's third down and long over the middle. That pass could be picked off. It may be. They will say intercepted by the Bison. Carlton Littlejohn. His second pick of the year.
Little job from his linebacker position. Did he get his hands underneath that one? And here Bell just indecisive with the throw. Little John, great job just reading the quarterback's eyes. Does he have it? You know, he does a good job of showing the ball right away. See, once he has it, they're looking to see, and you've got to show it to him. Good job of getting that right arm underneath, showing the officials I've maintained possession. That's a big play by Carlton Littlejohn.
I'm going to take another look at it, but I believe that'll be a...
The ruling on the previous play is a turnover, catch, and interception. The play is under further review.
When you talk to defensive coordinator Chris Kleiman about Carlton Littlejohn, he said he's an unsung hero on this defensive unit. Gets overshadowed by Grant Olsen because of the number of tackles that Olsen has with the 146 on the season. But Littlejohn's a guy that does the little things you need to be an effective defense. And once you leave your feet, it's almost like a wide receiver. Once you leave your feet and you're going to the ground, it's important that you show the ball to the official right away so that he knows that you maintain possession of the ball. He's got it there. He's got his arm underneath.
That's a that is a catch. I don't think.
And there was an angle we saw earlier where he was able to actually cup the ball in his right hand and have that glove underneath the football.
There's Littlejohn. Of course, he had the play of the game at North Dakota State in the Fargo Dome against Georgia Southern as he blocked the 50-yard field goal attempt with 20 seconds left that preserved the victory for the Bison.
The ruling on the play stands.
So the second interception of the day for Brian Bell. He came in with just 7 picks all season. And now North Dakota State has it at the 40-yard line, first down and 10. Their first possession of the third quarter. Jensen out of the I formation, hands it off to O'Jury. And Sam with a big hit will pick up 8 on the play. Michael Wade in on the tackle for the Bearcats.
And what they're doing, they're having success running the ball to the left side, and that's where their best offensive lineman is, Billy Turner, 6'5", 300 pounds. If you can find a way to get the ball on this side, he's going to clear it out. Good kick block there, follow up with the fullback lead. That's North Dakota State Bison football.
There goes Smith in motion. But Jensen will throw it. He's hit. Off the fingertips of Zach Vaughn. And Jensen took a shot right as he let go of the football.
Had Jensen had the ability to reset his feet on this throw here. Robert Shaw coming from his safety position on the blitz. Got there just a second earlier than Jensen anticipated, forcing him to release the ball sooner. Long incomplete pass.
So now it's 3rd down and 2. Couple of tight ends. O'Jury's the running back. And Jensen will take it himself and pick up the first down. Well, it's spotted at the 47. Gain of 6 on the play.
I think we're going to see North Dakota State, when they choose to run the football, it's got to go to the left side. Find a way for Billy Turner to win his one-on-one matchup and just push the pile forward.
Stacked receivers to the far side. High formation. Here goes Sam O'Jury. Gain of 4. O'Jury chasing down a 1,000-yard season. Came in with 955 yards on the ground. O'Jury today has 16 Crockett went over 1,000 when he picked up a 57-yard rush back in the first half. And Crockett in the game now as Ojuri takes a breather on second down and 6. Here comes some pressure. Nice catch by Crockett on the near sideline. They'll mark it inside the 25, down to the 23, a 19-yard pickup. Great throw from Jensen under duress.
Take a look here. Watch Brock Jensen recognize the corner blitz is coming from here. He realizes he's going to have a wheel route out of the backfield. If he has enough time to get rid of it, he knew one-on-one coverage. Great touch. One guy trying to change directions. Great recognition by Brock Jensen.
Boy, if Crockett can keep his feet, that is a touchdown for the Bison. That first down and 10. Inside the 25. Ojuri, handoff right side. And runs into a wall of orange jerseys. A gain of 3 on the play, led by Dax Swanson, the senior corner out of Waco, Texas, making a play. And remember, no Darnell Taylor in that defensive secondary, the best player on this defense, best player defensively in the Southland Conference. Left in the first half what appeared to be a knee injury. Couple of tight ends on second down and 7. Drive started back at the 40-yard line of North Dakota State. Ojuri inside the 15. Give him 8. Darius Taylor brings him down. That'll be close to a first down. It will be a first down as they move the chains.
It seems as if both teams are starting to go to their bread and butter. You know it's power football for North Dakota State. In the first half, they did not challenge the Bearcat defense in the middle of the defensive line. Now in the second half, the adjustment has been, we've got to go out there and enforce our will on this stingy Bearcat defense, and the Bison are having success here in the second half.
8th play of this drive. 2 passes, 5 runs. They'll hand it off to Smith. Dancing inside the 5. Close to the first down. They'll spot it at the 4. Needs about another half a yard. Garrett Bruhn.
Yeah, you see Garrett Bruhn, going to do a kickout block number 47. That's Bruhn right there on the chop block. And then there was all Ryan Smith after that. Hard cut into the middle.
So it'll be second down and short, Jay. And that clock moves under 9 minutes to go here in the third quarter. This has been classic North Dakota State football on this drive.
If I'm North Dakota State, I'm running the ball to the left side behind my left tackle, Billy Turner.
Turner, the All-American. They will go behind him. They will say Ojuri is just shy of the goal line.
They may need to take a look at this one. He had a great surge on this one. It seemed that he extended the football to cross the goal line. Great job getting to the left side.
Well, North Dakota State in the hurry-up mode, out of the eye. Jensen will take it, and he will follow that offensive line in for a touchdown. His 10th rushing touchdown of the year from a yard out has given North Dakota State the 6-point advantage. So for Jensen, his 2nd rushing touchdown this afternoon. The first from 20 yards, that one from a yard out. Here is Adam Keller to attempt the point after. And Keller will split the uprights. Boy, that was just, if you want to know what North Dakota State's offense looks like, just watch that drive over and over again. 10 plays, 60 yards, 4.5 minutes off the clock. They lead by 7.
This year, share everything. Share brotherly love. Share one-ups.
Mom?
The Share Everything plan lets your family share a pool of data across 10 devices with unlimited talk and text.
Get a Spectrum 2 by LG for $49.99.
Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you 1% cash back on all purchases, plus a 50% annual bonus, and everyone likes 50% more.
Jenner! Yeah!
50% more.
You know what I mean?
50% more flash.
50% more taters. That's where talks come from.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you 1% cash back on every purchase, plus a 50% annual bonus on the cash you earn. It's the card for people who like more cash.
50% more spy stuff. What's in your wallet?
This car's too small.
For an incredible world, you need an improbable vehicle. So we engineered the new Mazda CX-9 to be both spacious and agile. We designed it to be utilitarian, yet stylish. And we made the CX-9 sophisticated, but kept it within reach. The improbable is now possible. Introducing the Mazda CX-9. Reimagined for 2013. We build Mazdas. What do you drive?
You're watching the NCAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Good look at the record crowd here at FC Dallas Stadium. A stadium record today for this matchup. A repeat of a year ago. North Dakota State won it 17-6 last year over Sam Houston State. They lead 17-10 now.
Some of the key plays while the Bison were able to get the lead. It seemed as if Sam Houston was going to have the lead on a Flanders touchdown, but there was a penalty. Then the interception by Carlton Littlejohn, and Brock Jensen showing you the touch, recognizing where the pressure was coming from. Then at the end of the day, called his own number. Second touchdown run of the day for Jensen, and the Bison have a 7-point lead.
And North Dakota State has taken advantage of those Sam Houston State turnover to the tune of 14 points. That last drive, 10 plays, 8 of them on the ground. LeCompte to kick it away. Trey Diller out of the end zone. Trey looking for a little bit of room, and there is none. He'll get it to the 17, and that is where the Bearcats will start this drive. Antonio Rogers with that special teams tackle for North Dakota State. Let's go back and take a look at our Sam Houston State impact players and give you a little update.
Well, Flanders tried to have a huge impact, but unfortunately there was a holding call on the play, but he's been effective there. Sincere's been able to get it done. He's been very effective for them as well. And unfortunately, we lost one of the Taylors. We won't have Darius Taylor in this football game. He's out with an injury. So, Darnell Taylor, pardon me. The linebacker is Darius Taylor. He's still around, but that's what our impact players for Sam Houston State have done.
So here's Sincere at quarterback, takes the Wildcat snap out over the 30. The pile still going to the 32-yard line. That'll be a gain of 15 and a good start on this drive for the Bearcats. Sincere averages 6 yards a carry. And now he's got 8 for 22. He had suffered a 9-yard loss on a sack when he tried to throw out of the Wildcat.